Well, the Nova Launcher is dead, and I've been looking for alternatives. Many of the people suggested Microsoft Launcher. Here's my review so you don't have to waste your time trying it out, and if it can be as great as the Nova Launcher, to even replace it.
So I've been using it for a couple of weeks on my main smartphone, but start from the start so you know how the experience is. So after installing this app, you are greeted with this Microsoft Launcher, and they of course ask you to sign in to Microsoft. And right away they want your location, so I don't want to give them my location. But whatever, you'll have to give a lot of permissions. You may choose not to sign in. I guess they use this to sync your backup or whatever. And no, I don't want to help them improve it. So basically, you can log in with Microsoft and add Microsoft related stuff to your calendar, like even your office work to your previous home screen. And let's see if it is able to get it. So I have it up as default. I did not have many apps on my default launcher, but it sort of imported it pretty well. So right away, you will have a few options, as you can see here. On the left, you do not have the Google pane, and I did not find any option to actually go through it and add a pane. You can basically have a to-do list, sticky notes or whatever. So basically these are Microsoft apps, and they also show you basically your activity content, like how much you have used each app. You have screen time, so you could turn it on, but here you would have to give them the accessibility access. It is able to understand what all apps I'm using, and it gets better over time. I think this is pretty useful to get a feel for, you know, what kind of things you have going on and what apps you use. So let's jump in right into the settings and see what kind of customization options you get here. And you have the system settings, which is of course your settings, and you also have the option to choose a new wallpaper every day, and you get a shortcut for it as well on the home screen, so that is pretty neat. So let me see if I can find it. So I'll just go to the widgets, and yeah, so you have this wallpaper option. You just add it up and it will change your wallpaper. I think I'll sort of like this. I just don't like this Bing icon on the corner, but it's whatever. And they have their weather app and everything. So you can add this total screen time and everything. These are default ones. You can also add the weather app. You can set the location and it will show you the weather. But let's jump into the settings that you have here. You have the option for different themes. You can set the opacity blur effect. And you also have different icon and size layouts. As you can see, there are a lot of options here. And you can change the icon size. You have like a lot of customization. I did not expect to find this much customization here, but it is there. You can also choose a different icon pack. You can download new icon packs. As you can see here, you can use basically any icon pack with this one, which is something I really like about this launcher. You have the option to change the folder appearance. So as you can see, it really has a lot of customization options. If you want to show this thing, you have to give Microsoft notification access, and yeah. And you can also hide certain apps, which is pretty cool if you want to hide your apps from your girlfriend or, I don't know, whoever, maybe your parents. And you have the option to scroll to switch the apps, but I guess I have to restart the launcher for that. And you also have the option for double tapping to close the phone. For that, you have to give it access, admin access maybe, or the accessibility access. The accessibility access would work better, as you can see here. You have the dock mode. So what it basically does, you swipe up here and you can get the dock. I sort of wanted to get the app list for me, and this sometimes got confusing, but I think it can be good for people who want to keep apps handy here. Let's quickly jump in. As you can see here, you can always show it, hide it, turn it off. And you have the number of rows you want to show for the dock and number of columns and certain customization options. These are self-explanatory. You can change the type of grid. You can have the alphabetical list. And yeah, as you can see here, you have pretty neat options here. And you also have multiple gestures, and I love these gestures. I always enable double tap to sleep, which is pretty useful, but you have to give the access for that. And you can do all sorts of things like pull it down to open the app drawer or expand the notifications. I generally expand the notifications because it comes in handy to me. And you can basically edit your feed. You have all kinds of options. And you can add a few widgets to there. So I think that is pretty cool that you can add widgets there too. So you could basically have a list of widgets. This is a feature that I really like. But so far I have not really found an option to enable the Google feed if that's something you're into. I was sort of used to it. And of course they have Google Bing as the default search engine. But I know you know it. Everyone is going to switch it to Google. You have search bar style. You have different filters. Like you can also link Outlook. You can add people to it, to the search option. This is basically within the search option that you have. and you can delete the history here as well. And apart from that, you also have a nifty backup and restore feature, which can be useful if you are switching phones or just changing launchers, uninstalling it, reinstalling it. And you have basically this option here to search. You can basically search your contacts. But one thing I really don't like is that they prompt you. This is not just because I've just installed it. I had installed this Microsoft launcher in my main phone for a while, and even still I would get this notification kind of thing that, okay, install it. I don't want to install it, but yeah, they will bug you to install it just like they do it on Windows. And sometimes when I'm searching for an app, it searches random things and it doesn't really show the actual app. That has happened a lot of time. Like, let's say I want to open this app files, I would search for files, but it would start showing me random stuff and not actually show the app. So that's sort of a bug that is sometimes present, but it's not that annoying. So overall, I'm pretty impressed with this particular launcher. It has its share of good amount of features. I like that it has a lot of customization available, and it is pretty stable. It works well, and it is supported by Microsoft, so you don't have to worry about it going out of date and getting, you know, killed off. So I think overall this is a great browser that is worth trying out. But is it better than Nova Launcher, or could it replace Nova Launcher? No, not at all. Nova Launcher is still number one in my heart, and I'm going to use it until it stops working or bugs out.